Коли люди приходять і дивляться на солом'яні вироби,
when people come and look at products that are made from straw, they first perceive them as decorations or some kind of a toy for children. But all these things were created for entirely different reasons, and their purpose was much more serious. It may seem to some people to be a very simple process, but it's much more difficult than they could imagine.
І ще й по сьогодні не зрозуміло.
Можете зрозуміти, скільки треба зробити.
Just imagine how many efforts you need to apply in order to grow such select material from which to braid.
Якщо подивитися з наукової точки зору, то там можна подивитися.
From a scientific point of view, you can see a helix that resembles RNA and DNA.
Якщо дивитися з точки зору,
if you look from the point of view of symbolism, then again you will see a spiral, which is a natural symbol of the infinity of human life or ultimate continuity. In life you have to be real, and we should remember that a human in this life is none other than an integral part of nature. If a person is in unity with nature and in constant harmony with nature, and they feel at least a grain of this in their heart and soul, then they will feel more and more goodness every day.
Довкола нас буде більшати, більшати і більшати. А ви бачили коли-небудь, як росте пшениця?
Have you ever seen how wheat grows? How the wind pumps in? How waves of wheat move from one side to another?
І коли приходиш на таке поле,
and when you come to such a field, you look at it, stand still mesmerized by it, and remember such words you once read in a book. Once upon a time, a ray of the sun fell on the earth, hitting a green stalk of a wheat ear, or better said, a chlorolific grain.
Пшеничної рослини, або краще сказати, хлорофілове зерно, він
it extinguished, and there was no longer any light. But it did not disappear. Instead, it turned into bread that served us as food. It gave strength to our muscles, our nerves, and it warmed our bodies. And perhaps it was right at that moment that it was playing with our thoughts. I'm often asked how much time I spend braiding my products. I respond, just sit next to me and count how much time and effort it takes. What should I do to create such works? First of all, I have to plow the field, sow the rye, wait until it grows, go to the field more than once and see if the ear has ripened. You must understand that rye has its ripening period, and only after that I proceed to its preparation. Once my grandfather, teaching me how to braid from straw, told that it is impossible to gather bread twice. Either take good straw for braiding or wait until the grain ripens, thresh it, and bake bread. I still have straw bread and collect straw for braiding. This is not determined by the calendar. For this you need to go to the field. Take the straw in your hands and check whether it is suitable for braiding or is no longer suitable. And it is this period from the beginning when you can braid something from a straw until the moment when it is no longer possible to use it for braiding and is only suitable for harvesting the straw. Straw is prepared very simply. Take an ordinary sickle, reap the ears and fold it. The crumpled straw is absolutely not suitable for braiding. In this case, it should be carefully folded, especially for storage. Imagine how much effort you need to put into growing such a selective material so that you can braid something from it.
уважно.
Going straw was also necessary to cover the roof of a house. In addition to that, straw must be grown according to special techniques in order that it will be suitable for creating such products. Each master determines for himself how much material he needs to do his work and how much he plans to braid. Sometimes I produce and other times not that much. But I always harvest straw so that I have a reserve and more than enough to work with. What exactly is a sufficient amount? For example, there are such years when we have a lot of rain, wind, or there are various diseases that can have an adverse effect on rye. In this case, the straw becomes unsuitable for braiding. It is either blackened by rain or broken by the wind. For this simple reason, a master should always take care of the stock of material with which he is going to work. I usually prepare more than enough a year in advance. If it is a successful harvest year and the rye grows well, I gather it, prepare it, and know that I am stocked up in case I will not be able to gather good straw. Any kind of straw is suitable for braiding. For the most part, I use rye because rye straw is the best for braiding. But traditionally, straw of all cereals can be used for braiding, including that of wild plants. Straw braiding is not only about the process itself. As in any craft, there are many things that are related to it, though they may not be directly related to the manufacturing process. The exact same principle applies to the craft of braiding straw. Therefore, first and foremost, straw braiding is associated with the cultivation of grain crops, rye in particular. And the cultivation of crops is a certain cycle of beliefs and rituals that are closely associated with the implementation of this very specific form of work. One of these rather interesting and very ancient unique elements is the tradition of placing wickers. A wicker is a simple wooden stick, at the end of which a bundle of straw is wound. Such sticks were put into the soil and fields near the village or along some rural paths. What function did they perform? First of all, informational. When a person went to engage in some hard labor, for example, threshing hay in the meadow, they caused a whirlwind, and in this way informed other people that this place had already been occupied, and no one else should work there. And everyone knew what that meant. If somewhere a path was laid along the field and the owner did not want it, then he put the symbol on the path. And in this case, it served as a sign of prohibition. It was a strict rule for everybody. If it happened that some kind of epidemic began spreading through the village, and it was in our history, typhoid, the plague, and other terrible diseases, they placed signs of wicked and deadly diseases around the village. So when a stranger approached the village, they understood that it was dangerous to even try to enter it, and they stayed clear. But there is another interesting moment, which is associated with the rites for the harvest. This is forecasting and controlling the weather. This is a kind of a magical ritual. It is known that in many villages, particularly in the mountains, wolfars lived. The local residents called them charmers. During the harvest season, they could maintain good weather so that the locals could harvest the crops on their land. There is such information that in Bukovina in western Ukraine, there were many of them. When they were doing their work, they always put on an overcoat, but they had to wear it on a naked body, and they carried a branch of a hazel tree in their hand, at the top of which there was a grain of wheat or rye. With the help of this very simple implement,
ліщинову палицю, на верхів'ї якої
they were able to disperse the clouds so that it would not rain on their crops.
Або жита. І от за допомогою цього нехитрого інструменту вони розганяли хмари. І от якщо прослідкувати
thunder.
Якщо прослідкувати
if to follow all these processes, why then the word straw charmer as a derivative of straw cannot be explained by modern day science?
Як похідне від солома, хоча воно має спільний корінь із соломою.
Though it has a common root with straw, they left the straw explanation of the word straw man, or weaker man, when religion left its mark on public life.
Свій відбиток на суспільне життя внесла релігія. І от тоді воно відбулося за добре відомим і нині принципом, якщо ми
And then everything happened according to the scheme known today. If we cannot control something, then we can explain it in the way that benefits us. So it was explained that the word Solomonar originated from the name of some saint. But if to make an analogy between the wicker that we mentioned earlier and this stick with orifices and several grains on the top, then they're quite similar. For this reason, the opinion that Solomonars disperse clouds with the help of such straw wickers is quite viable. So it is not in vain that in Christmas carols people sing, wickers from the heavens are a blessing for people. So when is there joy for people? It is when there is a good harvest, when people have strong health, when people feel no back pains during the harvest, and when there is favorable weather. That is when people are happy. And nobody else but Solomonars could bring people such pleasantries.
Коли люди приходять і дивляться на солом'яні вироби,
when people come and look at products made of straw, they first perceive them as decorations or a kind of toy. But all these things were created for completely different reasons, and their purpose was much more serious. Most of these things were an integral part of some kind of ritual.
І дуже складним і ще й по сьогодні незрозумілим. Переважна більшість цих речей
They were made in the process of this ritual. There were participants in the ceremony. They performed their function, and at the end of the ritual, they disappeared. They were drowned in a river or a lake, or were burned on a bonfire. Among all these elements, there is one particular one that we call today Vertun, and sometimes in another place it can be called Baba or a woman. What is the difference? Vertun is such a spiral figure, and the woman doll had spikelets attached to their clothing below. Such forms of vertuns and baba are characteristic for all peasants around the world. They may not be called vertuns and baba, but in their form and in the method of production, they're all identical. From a scientific point of view, there you can see a spiral that resembles RNA and DNA.
Пізнати спіраль, яка символізує РНК і ДНК.
While from the point of view of symbolism, the same spiral symbolizes the infinity of human life and continuity. There you can see lines, which are a symbol of a sown field, which is inherently a symbol of rain.
І багато чого іншого там можна призначити, побачити. Багато хто сьогодні думає, що такі вироби могла зробити кожна людина.
Nowadays, many believe that anyone can make such products. Moreover, everyone should be able to do this, especially children in schools, to make a pisanka, a painted egg, or a motanka, braided doll. And everyone should know how to braid from straw. But this is a misconception. This was never done in large numbers, and there were certain periods in the annual calendar when this was supposed to be done.
Коли це повинно було робитися. Наприклад, павуки
For example, spiders were used as Christmas decoration and were made only during Christmas. What do we call amulets? When people come to us and ask whether these are amulets, I tell them that the guardian is a belief. And they seem to get frustrated because I'm not telling them what they wanted to hear. Sometimes, when talking with people, I hear, you say something incomprehensible. In this case, I answer that I always know what I'm saying, but I don't always tell everything that I know. In life, you have to be observant. Some say we need to be philosophers. Philosophy is a convention. Just like everything else in this life, a lot of different conventions. In life, you have to be real. And we should remember that a human in this life is none other than an integral part of nature. If a person is in unity with nature and in constant harmony with nature, and they feel at least a grain of this in their heart and soul, then they will feel more and more goodness every day.
Довкола нас буде більшати, більшати і більшати.